Take some crab. It can be Dungeness king crab, blue crab, green crab, rat crab, you know, any kind of crab you got. We all love crab. Hello, Brian Malarkey here with Health Monitor TV, and we're having some fun in the kitchen. We're keeping it easy. We're keeping it real. We're keeping it light. We're keeping it healthy. I'm here with my best man, Chops. Seersucker Scottsdale, Arizona in the house. All right, I've got restaurants in Austin, Seersucker coming right now, and we've got a lot of restaurants in San Diego. If it's got a fabric name in San Diego, it's one of ours. But right now, we're talking about Seersucker. This is an amazing dish. So what we're doing here is there's this thing that happens in Southern California and Arizona. It's like, I can't eat carbs and that, you know? A lot of people say they are, what is it when you can't
celiac.
Eat? Celiacs. Well, those people, I'm very sorry, because that's a real thing. But the rest of the people that just want to be a little bit skinnier, this is a way, and this is for all of you, all right? So this is great because we don't use bread, and most of the time restaurants use bread and crab cakes to actually fill up and make a filling out of it. And it's essentially their way of actually trying to save some money
right.
and use as little amount of crab as possible because we all love crab. But here at Seersucker, we are trying to give you as much crab as possible. So we want to come up, we want to eliminate the carbs, eliminate the bread. And so our only thing we had to do was make the crab stick together because a cake doesn't fall apart, a cake sticks together. So what we do here is we take some crab, it can be Dungeness king crab, blue crab, green crab, rat crab, you know, any kind of crab you got, right? Is that true?
True story.
Yep. All right, and then we made a little bit of aioli, or actually we did a little bit of mayonnaise, all right? So mayonnaise, yes, maybe not the healthiest thing in the world, right? We actually crack an egg into the mayonnaise, and that gives it a little bit more binding agent, right? All you really need is just enough of the mayonnaise, and you can get the light mayonnaise. You can actually make your own mayonnaise, and you can use extra virgin olive oil. You can use extra virgin olive oil so you have a different kind of fat going on in there. And then all we need to do is just essentially make it stick like that, season it up, a little salt, a little pepper, chicka 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 ching, right? That's all we need to do. You can in the seasoning, you can also put a little Old Bay, you can put some Tabasco, you can put some Worcestershire, you can put some fennel seed in there, anything you want, doctor it up. You can put a little tomato in there, a little bit of lemon because seafood loves lemon, right? And then all we're going to do is we're going to take a little mold, and here we're going to show you the finished product right now. In the big restaurant world, we have these molds right here. Show them what we got, Chops. But at home, what I like to do is I like to take like a muffin pan, right? So if you're having some little finger food, some hors d'oeuvres, you take the little muffin pan and you put a little scoop of this right in there. You can get a little ice cream scoop, or you can just kind of put a little ball. You can actually kind of freeform them also. You can freeform them, bake them on a sheet tray. Doctor. Thank you. You can freeform them, or you can put them in the muffin pan, and then when your guests come over for that night, you know, you can do a little one for little hors d'oeuvres, you can do a medium-sized one for like a little crab cake, or you can do larger ones, and you can actually make like a crab cake sandwich, a crab cake burger, whatever you want. Put some bacon. Oops. Maybe not the healthiest. I'm talking the leanest turkey bacon in the world. The leanest turkey bacon in the world, right?
Absolutely.
All right. Doctor it up. Chops is what we call an amazing plater. Not only is he a great chef, a very funny guy, and a handsome man, he makes a plate just look sexy, right? All right. So he's put a little bit of this aioli we made on there. Again, if you don't want the mayonnaise, you don't want the egg backing, you can use a pesto, you can use a chimichurri, you can use so many different combinations, right? Most importantly is not over doing it because the crab is delicate. It's sweet. It's amazing. The fresher it is, the better it is, the less you want to do. Chops, what in tarnations are you putting on this? What is that?
As Chef was saying, you know, a little heat is always good. This is Tabasco caviar. Something
what?
With the restaurant.
Tabasco laid eggs? I don't understand, Chops.
We thought it was a little agar. Just set it up.
Agar? What's agar?
Seaweed. It's good. You're still healthy.
Woo!
No worries.
That's hot.
And then this is something, too, is also is great. You can make the night before. So if you're having friends and family over, you don't have to worry about the next day. Pop
you
the
made Tabasco caviar. I'm still perplexed. I'm not. I've seen it before. all right, and then what are these little green things right here?
Just chives, just some fresh herbs. You can do a nice little micro salad.
I've never seen any chives like that before.
We get special products.
Wow.
Down the street.
Oh, those are like baby chives, right? So they don't get to grow up and be big chives. They're just little baby chives, but we cut them and they're so sweet and so nice and got a little bit of spice. All right, so there it is. So like I said, you can do any combination you can put in there, all the different flavors you want. If you have celiac disease, you're not eating the bread. If you don't like carbs, this is the best thing for you because we all love crab, all right? So have some fun with this. You can put some Dijon mustard in there. You can put whatever you want. Have some fun with it. Essentially, it's just the egg and a very, very little bit of the oil from the mayonnaise. If you want to make your own, you can do that at home. A different kind of sauce if you want, a different dressing, a vinaigrette. Keep it light. Keep it fun. Don't bother. Don't try to make the Tabasco caviar at home. Come see Chops. Again, Brian Malarkey and Chops from Health Monitor TV. All right. See you on the next segment.